Welcome to my fast-paced series on the hardest SAT practice problems. In this video, we're studying geometry. Just like I used to in elementary school with Pythagoras. Make sure to stay to the end when I share a full list of hardest questions.
Let's go! Solve your math problems.
Now, tap pause to try problem one on your own.
This is a geometry problem, and every geometry problem is solved the same way. Draw a picture, label the picture, and write an equation. Start drawing the picture immediately. Now, label the picture. What does it mean to have a perimeter of 1,200 in an equilateral triangle? Each side will be 400.
This is because in each Dorito lateral triangle, you have three equal angles, all 60 degrees, and three equal sides.
Now, add the height to the drawing. This segment is 200. It's time to write an equation. Do you know what equation to use? It is the Pythagorean theorem. Do you know the Pythagorean theorem? It's a squared plus b squared equals c squared. In my opinion, the Pythagorean theorem is the most famous formula in geometry. So if you don't know it, I need to see you after class. Once you use the Pythagorean theorem and some quick maths, it's clear that the height is 200 times the square root of 3. So the final answer is z equals 200. You may have recognized this as a 30, 60, 90 triangle. And this problem makes it very clear that in a 30, 60, 90 triangle, the short leg is always one half the hypotenuse. And the medium leg is always the shortest leg times the square root of 3. I must not be a 30, 60, 90 triangle because I just have two short legs.
Let's quickly review that last problem. The question was asking for the value of z, and z had to deal with the height, so we knew we needed to draw a height in our triangle. But what did we know about our triangle? Well, it was an equilateral triangle with a perimeter of 1,200. Equilateral triangles have three equal sides and three equal angles, so we were able to take the perimeter of 1,200 and split it evenly into 400 on all three sides. Once we drew the height, that split the bottom side into pieces of 200 each. That created a 30, 60, 90 triangle. And we can either use the Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, or the fact that in a 30, 60, 90 triangle, the shortest side is always one half the hypotenuse, and the medium side is always the shortest side times the square root of 3. So with the shortest side of 200, the height is 200 times the square root of 3.
Based on the new practice test, geometry makes up about 15% of the questions, which is about twice as much as it was before. So maybe you shouldn't have slept through geometry class after all.
Now, tap pause to try problem two on your own.
They already drew the picture, so it's time to label it and write an equation. It's time for some Dadvice. When you have a circle problem, immediately decide if it's an area problem or a circumference problem. If the problem says area, it's an area problem. Otherwise, it's a circumference problem. Here, they were being nice and told us the circumference is 160 pi. Notice that arc AC is 3 times the length of arc CB. So let's mark that and see what we can do. The circle is really being broken into 8 parts. So arc CB is 160 pi divided by 8. That's 20 pi. So one slice is 20 pi, and AC is triple that, so it's going to be 60 pi.
We've got one problem left. If you've just got a little bit smarter, please like this video. Don't forget to subscribe and share it with your friends.
Now, tap pause to try problem 3 on your own.
Here, the dream-crushing sociopaths at the SAT were angrier than usual. But it's a geometry problem, and every geometry problem is the same. So draw the picture, label the picture, and write an equation. Once you have your cargo crate drawn, now it's time to write the equation. To write the equation, you must spot the most important word in this problem. It is surface area. If you don't know what surface area is, it's the amount of wrapping paper that it would take to wrap an object, or the total area that would be covered if you painted the entire outside of the object. Do you have a different way to describe surface area? If so, please leave it in the comments. First, let's find the area of one crate. If we can imagine painting this end, the area that would be painted would be x squared. There's a matching square on the other end. So now we have 2x squared. Now, let's paint this side of the container. That's going to be an area of 15x. There are 4 of those sides, so that's 60x. The problem tells us to call the total surface area C, so we will set it equal to C. Now, we have to smash the two containers together and imagine painting the larger combined container. It's pretty much the same as painting the two separate containers, but we don't need to paint these two sides here in the middle. So we can remove those from the total. It says that this total should be equal to 8/5 C. Since we have two equations, this is a system of equations, and we can use the substitution method to place 2x squared plus 60x in for C and solve the combined equation. Since there are fractions, let me remind you, nobody likes fractions. So we should multiply this side by 5 and move it to the other side. Now we can distribute the 8 on this side and the 5 on that side. Since there are x squareds in this problem, it's another factoring problem. So we need to move everything to one side, then factor. Here, there's a GCF of 2x, leaving behind 2x minus 15 equals 0. After some quick maths, we get x equals 15/2.
Let's take a quick look back at the key moments in that last problem. We started in the question and spotted the most important word, which was width. So that told us it was a geometry problem. So we knew we needed to draw a picture, label the picture, and write an equation. Remembering that surface area is the amount of paint that it takes to cover a surface, we figured out that the area of each individual side and added them all together. Then we looked back to the problem and saw that we had to smash the two crates together. Next, we found the surface area of those two crates combined. Then, looking back at the question, we saw that the combined surface area was 8/5 C. So we set the two equations equal to each other. Then we got rid of the fractions because nobody likes fractions. And lastly, because it was an x squared problem, we realized we had to bring everything to one side, factor, and solve the equation.
Thanks so much for watching. Please like this video and a link to the list of all the hardest problems and the paper SAT practice tests is in the description. Please practice.